Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end. Also, if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on price to cash flow ratio. We are going to learn formula, how to calculate this ratio, and we are going to see the examples of the same. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. So first and the foremost thing, I'm going to show you a graph, basically a chart. As you can see over here, Chevron's price to earning ratio and Chevron's cash flow ratio. So the first and the foremost thing is that the currently the P ratio of Chevron is close enough to in the neighborhood of 149.88. So what do you think about Chevron's valuation? At the very first end, it is a definitely a sell. However, most of the analysts, they have given Chevron's either a strong buy or a buy rating. But none of the analysts has given a sell rating. Now, are they nuts? Why did they give buy rating to Chevron? Let me show you something. Can you see this trend? Over here, there is a strong buy. Over here, there is a buy. And over here, it is hold. So nowhere there is underperform or sell. At the very first end, looking at the price earning ratio, the call had to be different. The strong buy and buy is much more having, they are in much probability more. So you have to see something is here there. So of course the analysts are not looking just at price to earning ratio. They are going beyond those horizons and they are trying to explore something new. That's why there is a difference over here. The other multiples like earning value to BOE ratio, EV by EBITDA, price to cash flow ratio becomes rather more important. So let's get into this. See, from the above graph, the Chevron's price to cash flow ratio was close enough in the neighborhood of 16.01x. So in this tutorial, we'll look at how the price to cash flow ratio is useful in the valuation. At the very first end, at the inception, let's try and learn what is price to cash flow ratio. See, one of the most investment valuation ratio is P2C ratio, price to cash flow ratio. Many financial experts considered this ratio as more accurate measure of judging the attractiveness of an investment than the price to earning ratio. So there are very simple reasons behind it. In price to cash flow ratio, we consider the cash flow from the operations, which is the exact measure of how much cash came in and how much went out from the core operations. Unlike the cash flow, earnings can easily be manipulated because earnings, that is the net income, okay, get easily affected by depreciation and other cash factors. Can you see the net income over here? See the depreciation and depletion amortization expense. My goodness, 21,037. It is evaporating, or you can say it is boiling down the whole net income. And you can see the cash operations, cash provided by the operational activity is 19,456. So there are some things which are going wrong, right? So we note over here that cash flow from the operations like depreciation, depletion and amortization numbers were quite high in 2015. And it was higher than the overall cash flow from the operations. As you can see, 19,456. So you can say that though the price to cash flow ratio, you would be able to compare the cash flow per share with the price to with the price share, which will give you an idea about how much value you will get out of paying the kind of price you are going to pay. So if you want to invest into the company or project, price to cash flow ratio is one of the first one you should consider for computing. Now let's understand the formula for price to cash flow ratio. To get the thorough idea about the price to cash flow ratio, we need to look at the two separate ratio. Understanding the two separate ratio will help us to figure out how to compute the price to cash flow ratio. Let's look at the price to cash flow ratio first. See, P2CF, that is over here, I'm writing in short, price to cash flow ratio is equal to, price to cash flow ratio is equal to your share price divided by your share price divided by the cash flow per share. Okay, this is going to be your formula. So the ratio is basically is super useful for investor as they can understand whether the company is overvalued or undervalued. And however, to find out the ratio, we need to compute the cash flow per share. So to calculate the cash flow per share, we need two things. First, we need to know the operating cash flow, that is operating cash flow we just saw over there, and which we will be able to see in the cash flow statement of the company for that period. Second, we need to know the number of the outstanding shares. So this is the second thing that we need. So to calculate the cash flow per share, so the cash flow per share will be, I'm just writing cash flow per share is equal to, you will have operating cash flow divide by, you will have to do your number of outstanding shares. So your operating cash flows formula is this. Now, once we know the cash flow per share, we would be able to compute the price to cash flow ratio very easily. See, let's see the understand the interpretation of the same. Knowing the formula is not important, but interpretation is really important. Many investors get busy in computing price to earning ratio. But if you look at the price to cash flow, price to earning ratio, you would see that many companies can manipulate it to attract more investor. Like for an example, if there are many non-cash factors affecting the net income, companies which want to manipulate the net income can increase or decrease the non-cash factors. So the price to earning ratio is not always able to provide an accurate picture of the company or of a new investment. However, when we look at the cash flow, it changes the game completely. In cash flow statement, the non-cash factors would be included. Thus, there is no way one would manipulate the net cash flow at the end of the period. So if we can compute the operating cash flow, that is the, which we saw operations, that's what I told you in the very beginning. If we see the operating cash flow using the cash flow statement and divide it by number of the shares outstanding shares over here, then we'll be able to concentrate the idea about how much cash flow we can generate per share. And then we can compare the same with the price per share to conclude whether the investment is good or not. So if we try to find out the optimal ratio or optimal level of ratio, then we'll need to look at the particular sector. For example, if we look at the new technology startup, its growth would be much more faster, resulting into higher C2F. Okay. And if we look at the utility company which is operating for decades, the price to cash flow ratio would be lower for them. So in case of tech startup, as its growth is tremendous, the investors would put more valuation to it than the utility company, which has stable cash flow but fewer opportunities for the growth. Now let's understand the basic example of the same so that we get to know how things work out. There's a company called G Corporation, okay, and they have price per share as 10 per share. The cash flow per share is 4 per share. So from the example, we can directly compute the price to cash flow because we have both the things. So price per share and price to cash flow per share. We have both the things. Just divide A by B, we get 2.5, right? So at the very first end, depending on, as you can see, depending on the G sector, on which sector G Corporation belongs, we can compare the P2CF ratio and find out whether it is good at its number or not. Now, let's understand the second example. There is a company called MNC over here. They have given the price per share as 12 per share. They have given the operating shares and the outstanding shares. So over here, you need to calculate your denominator. So let's see how they have calculated. In this example, we have two things to compute. The first, we need to compute the cash flow per share. So we have operating cash flow divided by number of share, we'll get cash flow per share, and then the price to cash flow per share. See, the operating cash flow is 6 lakh. The outstanding share is 5 lakh. So the cash flow per share is 1.2 per share. Now, the next thing, the price per share is 12 per share, and we have got the cash flow per share as 1.2 per share, so our price to cash flow is going to be 10. So again, the similar thing is applicable in this regard as well. Depending on the sector this company belongs to, we need to compare the price to cash flow ratio and find out whether it is good number or not. Let's take another example to find out the cash flow ratio. Now over here, we have been given information regarding ABC company. There is a price per share, that is the market price per share. There are number of shares that are outstanding. There is net income over here, which is 70,000. Okay. Loss on the sale of property, 2,000. Decrease in accounts receivable, 1,000. So over here, we need to form the cash flow statement. Increase in the inventory, 2,000. Increase in accrued interest payable, 700. Increase in the accounts payable, 1,000. Deferred taxes, 500. And depreciation amortization, 3,000. So over here, we need to literally form the cash flow statement. From the details, at least it is visible. So from the above example, the first thing that we have to compute is the cash flow, right? So we have the net income that is given to us, 70,000, and we'll do some adjustment over there. So first, let's add back some of the non-cash expenditure, like that is depreciation, the deferred taxes, decrease in the account receivable, okay, that should be added, increase in the inventories, that should be deducted. Then there is accrued interest and accounts payable and sale of property. After making the adjustment of this, that is, you are basically forming the cash flow statement. That is, you are basically forming the net cash flow from the operating activity, which gives you around 76,200. After making all these adjustments, you get the net cash flow from the operating activity as 76,200. And we also know that the number of outstanding shares, so it would really be very easier to compute the cash flow per share. Now, the operating cash flow is 76,200. The outstanding share is 30,000. So your cash flow per share is 2.54. Once you get this, you have your price per share that is 12 and your cash flow per share is 2.54, which gives you your price to cash flow as 4.72. So the price to cash flow is 4.72. Depending upon the sector ABC company belongs to, we can compare to find out whether 4.72 is good enough number in regards to price to cash flow or not. Now let's see the price to cash flow ratio of Chevron's. If you see over here, the net income, some of the adjustments that have been made, just like what we did in our previous example number 3, in a similar fashion, things have been done over here, and you can see the net cash flow provided by the operating activities, which is 19,456. So let's see some details regarding 2013, 14 and 15. So the very first thing, Chevron's price to cash flow ratio in 2013 was 35,000, that is cash flow, sorry, the cash flow from the operations, as you can see over here, is 35,002 million. The number of shares in 2013 is 1917 million. And the cash flow per share in 2013 was 18.25. So because we have number of shares detail, we have the cash flow from the operations. So if we have both the details, we can get the cash flow per share, as we know very well. So the price to cash flow will be the price divided by the cash flow, that is the price to cash flow per share. So that gives you 6.33x. Now let's see the data for 2014. So in the similar fashion, things have been calculated, right? And we have again the price to cash flow ratio as 6.91. And for the 2015, it is 11.2x. So what do you understand? Over here, we note that the P2CF that we earlier saw for Chevron, 16.01x is the trailing 12 months price to cash flow. Now let's see some of the oil and gas company who are using this particular ratio. Now that we have very fair understanding, a very good understanding after analyzing the formula and some concepts, some examples, we'll compare some of the data for oil company like Exxon, Chevron, BP-PCF ratio. So over here, all three companies' price to cash flow ratio has been basically taking a great leap, or high, it's going up. So what do you have to say about this? See, the oil and gas price to cash flow ratio has been slowed down since 2013 and 14. Oil prices directly affect the cash flows. So due to lower oil prices, this company saw a really significant decline in their ratio in the cash flow from operation. So the oil and gas companies declining cash flow was a great hit to them. So with this reduced cash flow from operation in the recent quarters, the price to cash flow ratio for these companies who were in upward trend higher the price to cash flow ratio the expensive the firm is. So this was some of the details regarding the oil and gas sector. Can you see this table? Basically, this table is price to cash flow ratio of the top oil exploration and production companies. And you can see over here, there's a market cap, and over here, the ratio is there. You can see over here, the average price the ratio is 13.83x. So is it good or is it bad? So the one single answer to this is that, you know, some important points over here that we note over here is average price to cash flow ratio is 13.83. The EOG resources, okay, over here, And Pioneer Natural EOG Resources over here. And there is one more company, Pioneer Natural Resources. They both are two outliers in the sector with price to cash flow of 26.25 and 20.90. And if we remove the outliers, then the average PCF comes to only 11.36F. So, after looking at this, we should also look at the downside. There are some limitations to the price to cash flow ratio. So, there is only one limitation to this ratio. It is that, you know, it also has one loophole. And that is this, that it doesn't take capital expenditure into account. So, if you want to know the rigorous measure of this ratio, we need to extend beyond the price to cash flow. And we need to calculate the free cash flow and compare it with the price per share. So, the free cash flow is the amount of the cash flow which is available to the business after deducting the capital expenditure and computing the free cash flow may sound complicated. But here is the deal. All we need to do is that to go back to the income statement of the company and pick net income. Then we need to add back depreciation and amortization as they are non-cash charges. The next we'll take into account any changes in the working capital and thus we'll get the operating cash flow. Now, at the very final analysis, I can say that it can be easily be said that price to cash flow ratio is very useful for investor. It gives almost an accurate picture of how good an investment is. And the P2CF is useful because there is a little or no chance of manipulation in this cash flow. If as an investor, you would like to invest into new project or a new startup, use this ratio as measuring grid. And you can say that you can also use this ratio, but the price to cash flow ratio is by all means a better measuring grid. I hope you have got a great knowledge about this.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.